So, Michiko and Hachin, the final episode. I was very curious to what the DVD commentary would reveal about this, and we did get some interesting details. The commentary itself is coming from Christopher Bevins, the voice of Hiroshi and a voice director on the show, Monica Rial, the voice of Michiko, and Jade Saxton, the voice of Hachin. The first interesting detail we get comes from Monica Rial, and she's talking about this scene where Michiko and Hiroshi meet again for the first time. It ended up being really sweet, but Bevins had recorded like 10 different joke tracks for me, like "your hair smells like bubblegum," or like all kinds of weird stuff, so I couldn't stop laughing. Christopher Bevins then states that he did that in order to capture a feeling of being mad but happy at the same time. Monica Rial then reflects on times where they've gotten interviewed and asked about Michiko potentially being Hachin's mom. I think that does an injustice to their relationship, because it's cooler that they aren't blood related, and they come to care about each other so much, like family. It proves that family can be chosen sometimes. You can bring people in to be a part of your family. And that just surprised me, because I didn't even know that was like a running theory. Like, I've thought about that and thought, oh man, it would be cool, but I thought the show made it clear, like, no, she is not her mom. And then, like Monica Rial said, all the symbolism and stuff would kind of, not completely collapse, but it hits a lot harder that way. They also joked that Michiko would remember being pregnant, and that she probably would still dress the same and not wear maternity wear, so that was funny. Then she also gives her account of how she reacted when she found out how the ending was gonna play out. "I had that revelation, because I didn't know how it was gonna end. When we got the plane guy and he was like, 'Well, there's three of you?' And she says, 'No, two.' And I went, 'Aw, why am I going? I'm not going with them.'" Then from here, there were just like more tiny little details. Christopher Bevins joked that since Jade Saxton had to play like three different versions of herself, in this episode being younger Hachin, then older Hachin, and then also her baby, he said that she'd probably end up voicing her birth mom if she ever ended up in the show, so... yeah. Christopher Bevins also gave Jade Saxton some joke lines, and during this scene gave Jade Saxton a take that said something along the lines of, "Let's get a Taco Bell Crunchwrap Supreme and make a run for the border." So that was all pretty funny to hear. Last interesting piece I jotted down was Monica Rial talking about how inner monologue scenes are so much better, or she would think that they would be, because you don't have to worry about matching up with the lip flaps of the animation. And that was just another interesting thing about the process that I like to hear, and stuff that I don't really think about normally as a consumer watching. So I don't know. Let me know what you guys think. I appreciate you watching. Let me know how your day is going if you feel the need to. Good, bad, happy, or sad, I do read it. Links to the social media and the Discord in the description and comment section below. I hope you are loving yourself and taking care of yourself. If you are not, I know you can. Stay safe out there. Don't chase after somebody who ain't worth your time. And I think that's all my bases covered, so I'm about. Peace.